Hello, I'm back. It's been 5 months in my last video, but I'm here to stay. And guess what is also back? Exactly, my voxel game. I'll still be working on my voxel engine I showed in my previous video, I promise. But I want to finish a game before I'm dead. For this devlog, I basically focused on optimizing, rewriting, and fixing some stuff. I added multi-threading using Unity jobs to ease the process. I will probably have to write my own threading system in the future. But for now, jobs do the job. Now, the meshing of a chunk every time I break or place a block, or generate new chunks, is done in another thread, so the game does not freeze when meshing. I also changed the meshing. I'm now using the lowest level of meshes that Unity allows me, with vertex and index buffers, like I would do in OpenGL. This will also allow me to implement vertex packing, which I will get into after finishing light. Expect a video in 2 weeks. Please make sure to subscribe and hit that like button if you don't want to miss it. This change also allows me to optimize the block animation system, because now a block animation is done in the CPU each frame, updating the vertex position and then sending it to the GPU. Now, instead of literally passing all of the chunk into the GPU, I can only upload the specific vertices of the block, and that's of course much faster. As you can see, there is no FPS drops whenever I'm opening a chest. And this made me also rewrite the whole animation system, because it was not working correctly for animations with more than 2 frames. And also, I added a parameter to set the duration of an animation to make them slower or faster. And as you can see, it works flawlessly now. Once I've done that, I saw that there were huge FPS drops, from 1000 to 10. Taking a look at the profiler, I saw that the garbage collector was the main issue. So I changed all my code, switching from classes to structs, and implemented object pooling everywhere. And yeah, this worked, and I reduced a lot of the garbage collection. But there were still some eventual drops. Looking again at the profiler, I saw this. What that means is that the CPU was taking much less time preparing a frame than the GPU rendering it. So the CPU would stop and wait until the GPU was finished. The solution was as simple as increasing the amount of frames that the queue could store, so the CPU could continue preparing frames while the GPU was rendering them without blocking the GPU. One more task was to split my chunks into sub-chunks and layers, just like I did in the voxel engine, to basically reduce memory usage. And yeah, I'm using as well an object pool for arrays of blocks. Splitting the chunks into sub-chunks and then into layers also eases the process of adding light. I will talk more about it in my next video. And lastly, I rewrote also the item system, so it's easier for me to create different types of items. For now, I've got the block items, which basically allow me to place a specific block when pressing the action button. Summoning items will summon an entity. In Minecraft, for example, would be an ender pearl or an spawn egg. And casting items are the items that require a cast time to do something. You have to keep the action button pressed or else you will interrupt the cast. For example, a pickaxe to break stone. This also works for items that do not require a casting time. For example, swords when attacking. In this case, it will work exactly the same but setting the cast time to 0. With this, I can basically do any item I want with a specific behavior, whereas the other two types have a very restricted behavior. Also, I played with limiting the color palette of the game to make it look more retro, as some comments suggested in one of my previous videos, and I finally tried it. I think it looks really well and gives a cool retro vibe. I would like to know what you think about it, so please write your opinion in the comments. And that's it for today's video. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more updates.